Teams using private chat. In this video, we'll introduce you to private chat in Teams. In the left menu of Teams, select the chat function. Here you can start a new chat with a single person or a group. If you've never used chat before, you'll only see your own account underpinned. To start a chat, select the new chat icon in the top left. Enter the name or email addresses of a Department for Education staff member. Note that chat is disabled between students and between students and staff due to protective practices. If you've previously chatted with someone, you can see all your past conversations. This is known as persistent chat. Select the typing box at the bottom of the screen to start typing a message. To add additional lines of text, press Shift plus Enter for a new line, or select the A and pencil icon for more formatting options, including bullet points and tables. You can add emojis, GIFs, and stickers to your chat messages. Once you've finished composing your message, select the send icon in the bottom right. If the recipient has Teams open in their desktop, they receive a notification. Otherwise, they get an email alert. If the person is responding, you'll see their profile pop up with moving dots to indicate they're typing. An eye icon indicates they've seen the message and are replying. If you want to edit a message, hover over it and select the pen icon. This will allow you to edit the message and show a label indicating that it has been edited. There are a range of other options you can select from the three-dot menu, including delete, forward, copy link, pin, and reply. If you finish chatting with someone and don't want the chat visible in your left menu, right-click and select hide. This doesn't delete the chat, it just hides it from view. You can find the conversation again by typing the person's name when you start a new post and selecting Show Hidden Chat History. If you need to communicate regularly with a person, you can pin them so that they appear in the pinned section. To do this, select the three dots next to the person's name and select Pin. Within the chat, you can easily access files and links that have been shared. Select Shared from the top menu. Select Recent to see all items recently shared, or files and links to see these types of content. In the top right, you can add more people to the chat by selecting the Add People icon. This will start a new chat so that chat history is not shared. To rename the group chat, select the pencil icon next to the people field. Give your group chat a meaningful name and select Save. To start a video call, select the drop-down next to Meet Now in the top right. For a voice call without video, select the phone icon Audio Call. To share your screen without talking, select the three dots and select Screen Sharing. You can then choose to share your entire screen or a specific window. Note that screen sharing through chat doesn't allow the other person to control your screen. Once you select the content to share, the other person will receive a notification. When they accept, you'll see a red border around the screen you're sharing. You can also change the call to include video or audio after sharing your screen. By following these steps, you can effectively use private chat in Teams to communicate and collaborate with your colleagues.